What's a commode story?
It's a scene, man. Memorize it.
What?
Look, man, an undercover cop's gotta be Marlon Brando, right? To do this job, you gotta be a great actor. You gotta be naturalistic. You gotta be naturalistic as hell. Because if you ain't a great actor, you're a bad actor. And bad acting is bullshit in this job.
Yeah. What is this?
That's an amusing anecdote about a drug deal.
What?
Something funny that happened to you while you're doing a fucking job, man.
Damn. I gotta memorize all this? There's over 4 fucking pages
of
this shit.
Look, man, just think about it like it's a joke, all right?
You memorize what's important, the rest you make your own, all right?
You can tell a joke, can't you?
Nope.
Pretend you're Don Rickles or some fucking body and tell a joke, all right? Now, the things you gotta remember are the details. It's the details that sell your story. Now, this particular story takes place in a men's room. So you gotta know all the details about the men's room. You gotta know if they got paper towels or a blower to dry your hands with. You gotta know if the stalls ain't got no doors or not, man. You gotta know if they got liquid soap or that pink granulated powdered shit they used to use in high school, remember? You gotta know if they got hot water or not, if it stinks. If some nasty, low-life, scum-ridden motherfucker, man, sprayed diarrhea all over one of the bowls. You gotta know every detail there is to know about this commode. So what you gotta do is to take all them details, man, and make them your own. While you're doing that, you gotta remember that this story is about you and how you perceive the events that went down. The only way to do that, my brother, keep saying it, saying it, and saying it, and saying it, and saying it.
This was during the Los Angeles marijuana drought, 1986. I still had a connection, which was insane, because I couldn't get any weed any fucking where then. Anyway, I had a connection with this hippie chick up in Santa Cruz, and all my friends knew it. They give me a call, and they say, hey, Freddy. Say, hey, dude, you getting some? Get some for me too, like they knew I still smoked, so they asked me to buy some for them when I was buying for me. But it got to be, every time I bought some weed, I was buying for 4 or 5 different fucking people. Finally, I said, fuck this shit. I'm making this bitch rich. She didn't have to do jack shit. She never even had to meet these people. I was doing all the work. But then that got to be a pain in the ass. People call me on the phone all the fucking time. I couldn't even run a fucking tape without 6 fucking phone calls interrupting me. Hey, when's the next time you're getting some? Motherfucker, I'm trying to watch The Lost Boys, you know? When I get some, I'll let you know. Then these rinky-dink potheads come by. They're my friends and everything, but still, you know? I got all my shit laid out in $60 bags. They don't want $60 worth. They want $10 worth. And break it up is a major fucking pain in the ass. I don't even know what $10 worth looks like.
This is a very weird situation. Because I don't know if you remember back in 86, there was a major fucking drought. Nobody had anything. People were living on resin, smoking the wood in their pipes for months. This chick had a bunch. And she's begging me to sell it. So I told her I wasn't going to be Joe the Pot Man anymore, but I would take a little bit and sell it to my close, close, close friends. She agreed to that, said, we keep the same arrangement as before, 10% free pot for me, as long as I helped her out that weekend. She had a brick of weed she was selling. She didn't want to go to buy alone. Her brother usually goes with her, but he's in county unexpectedly.
What for?
His traffic ticket's gone warrant. They stopped him for something, found warrants on him, took him to county. Now, she doesn't want to walk around alone with all that weed. I don't want to do this. I have a very bad feeling about it. She keeps asking me, Finally, I said, okay, because I'm sick of hearing it. Now, we're picking the guy up at the train station.
Wait a minute. You go to the train station to pick up the buyer with the weed on you?
Yeah, the guy needed it right away. Don't ask me why. Anyway, we get to the train station, and we're waiting for the guy. Now, I'm carrying the weed around in one of those little carry-on bags. I got to take a piss. So I tell a connection, I'll be right back. I'm going to the boys' room. So I walk into the men's room, and who's standing there? 4 Los Angeles County sheriffs and a German shepherd.
They're waiting for you?
No, it's just a bunch of cops hanging out in the men's room talking. And I walk through the door, they all stopped what they were talking about, and they looked at me.
That's hard, man. That's a fucking hard situation.
German shepherd starts barking. He's barking at me. I mean, it's obvious. He's barking at me. Every nerve ending, all my senses, blood in my veins, everything I have is screaming, take off, man. Just
bail, just get the fuck out of there. Panic hits me like a bucket of water. First there's a shock of it, bam, right in the face. I'm just standing there drenched in panic, and all these sheriffs are looking at me, and they know, man, they can smell it. Sure as that fucking dog can, they can smell it on me.
Shut up.
Hey, so anyway, I got my gun drawn, right? And I gotta point it right at this guy. And I tell him, freeze, don't fucking move. And this little idiot's looking right at me, nodding his head, yeah, and he's saying, I know. But meanwhile, his right hand is creeping towards the glove box. And I scream at him. I go, asshole, I'm gonna fucking blow you away right now. Put your hands on the dash. And he's still looking at me, nodding his head, you know, I know, buddy. And meanwhile, you know, his hand is still going for the glove box. And I said, buddy, I'm gonna shoot you in the face if you don't put your hands on the fucking dash. And then this guy's girlfriend, this real sexy Oriental bitch, you know, she starts screaming at him, Chuck, what are you doing? Listen to the officer and put your hands on the dash. So, you know, then like nothing, the guy snaps out of it and casually puts his hands on the dash.
What was he going for?
His fucking registration.
Ha! You're kidding.
No, man, stupid fucking citizen doesn't know how close he came to getting blown away. That close, man.
You know how to handle that situation.